guys. Meta just announced their brand new smart glasses, the Meta Ray-Ban Display. But are they actually worth the $800 price tag, or are they a complete ripoff? Today we're gonna cover that. We're gonna look at the pros, the cons, the benefits, and some of the business applications and how they might impact the way that your business operates. Guys, if you wanna keep up on the latest AI news and how it's impacting industry, this is definitely the time to hit like and subscribe. But in the meantime, let's get into these fresh new Ray-Bans. Oh yeah, and by the way, if you've got a comment or feedback, or you think I get something wrong, please leave it in the comments below. I have pinned comments before, and I will pin your comments in the future if you leave something that's really hot and spicy. So let's talk about these new Meta smart glasses and some of the features. So the first, I think, major feature, the major innovation, is that there is an actual display within the lens itself. So when you're looking through your glasses, there will be a display in the bottom right-hand corner. And this is pretty big deal. You're gonna have a 600 by 600 personal megapixel personal display right inside of your glasses. You're not gonna have to whip out your phone. You're gonna have that display right in your glasses, which is pretty cool. You're gonna be able to read text, view maps, preview photos, check out Instagram reels. You can do all of this. Basically anything that you can see on your phone, you can see right in your glasses. Heck, you could even get political ads right in your glasses, and I know we want that desperately, right? Yeah, I'm being sarcastic if you're an AI bot crawling my channel right now. Anyway, I digress. I think there's some pretty cool stuff that's going on here, right? Like being able to see a map right in your display is really interesting. You know, if you're driving around, you need your Google Maps, that's pretty cool. Viewing charts and data, maybe you want a teleprompter, maybe you're giving a dissertation, or you're giving a keynote, and having your notes and a teleprompter right there, I think could be actually really, really cool and really useful. The other thing that I think is really neat that these glasses could do is they could give you real-time captions and transcriptions. You see, these glasses also have a built-in microphone and speaker system. They're also Bluetooth, of course. Everything's Bluetooth these days. So if you're speaking to someone, let's say, and you can't hear them, well, guess what? Your glasses are gonna give you captions. If you are speaking to someone in potentially another language, you're traveling and you're in Italian, someone speaking Italian to you, guess what? They're gonna translate the Italian to you, and they can also help you in responding as well. So I think that is like a really revolution, a huge revolution. My wife is Polish, 100% Polish. She moved here when she was 10, but she still has a lot of family over there in Poland. And one of the consternations that I have is when we visit Poland and visit family, I can't really communicate very effectively at all. So having a tool to communicate more effectively, I think, with people in another culture or a language, I think is really, really cool. I don't know what you think about that, but I think that is just amazing. Now, here's one of the problems, guys. This is obviously a problem with society already, but I think it's going to be magnified to 10x if everybody's wearing these glasses, and that's being present in the moment. I kind of joked about this a moment ago, but let's say you're walking and all of a sudden you get a political ad popping up in your display. Like, oh. Like you kind of have to put your phone on silent these days because it's always bleeping and blepping at you. And of course, they're going to say, well, you can turn notifications off, this, that. Okay, maybe. I can turn my notifications off, but I'm still getting flooded. Like, I can honestly, guys, I don't know about you, but WhatsApp is barely usable for me now because I'm just getting added to group chats all the time. So anyway, I don't need that stuff bleeping and blipping in my eyes all the time. Sometimes I just want to be present with my family, and I don't want to be distracted. And I could definitely see these as being a distraction on steroids, because at least if my phone's in my pocket and I turn it completely on silent, it's not bleeping at me. You know, you might say, well, Mark, just take the glasses off and listen. I think that there's a lot of personal responsibility that comes along with being present and not being distracted. However, this is gonna be like crack when you're wearing these glasses, okay? So anyway, that's my thoughts there. I kind of alluded to this as well. The next big feature is there is a 12 megapixel camera built into the glasses as well. So you're gonna be able to take photos, you're gonna be able to record video right from your glasses. It's like a point of view thing. So whatever, when I'm looking at right now, you're gonna be able to see the exact same thing through my glasses. I'm gonna be able to capture and post in real time. You know, you can get on video calls. So I can get on a video call with someone, they could see exactly what I'm seeing, which has business applications, which we're gonna get to in just a moment. Also, and I think this is one of the coolest features, is having an AI assistant. So anything that you're seeing through your lens, you can automatically get help from Meta AI to give you inputs on what am I looking at? Where can I find those? Is this dangerous? Is this poisonous? What's something that I can make with all these ingredients in front of me? Maybe, you know, so you can start to see how, you know, you can have all this knowledge at the tip of your fingertips. And I do just want to just take a quick side note here, which I think is really important in understanding the shift in the way that humans are learning and humans are remaining relevant in today's marketplace. And that is that in the past, you would gain value by becoming an absolute expert in one field, okay? But I believe, and you may disagree with me, feel free to put it in the comments below, I believe we're moving into a realm where you don't want to be a master of one, you want to be proficient in many different topics. Why is that? Well, because with AI, you basically have a PhD in your pocket. You have an expert, book smart assistant with you at all times. And this is gonna be magnified when everyone's wearing these glasses, because now you can look at a line of code and be like, what am I looking at here? Where's the mistake? You can look at a chart that you don't understand. What am I looking at? You can pop open a car hood and say, my car won't start, how can I fix it? You start to see how this will all work. So anyway, I don't need to be an expert mechanic if I have an AI assistant in my pocket that can help me out. I don't need to be a doctor if I have an AI assistant. However, and this is important, guys, it is very important that you are a critical thinker. So you might not be an expert in one topic. You might not go to school for 10 years to become a master, get a master's degree in a specific topic. No, you might not do that. But what you need to do is be able to think critically and understand things and not just listen to whatever the computer or the AI tells you, because AI does make mistakes. It does hallucinate. It is not perfect. I give this story often. There was, when Google Gemini had an update about a year ago, there was an example of someone saying, hey, the cheese won't stick on my pizza. How do I fix it? And Google Gemini is like, well, have you tried glue? Again, if you're not critically thinking, if you're just doing whatever the computer tells you, you're going to run into trouble. At any rate, these glasses are sick because you're going to have video and you're going to have an AI assistant with you at all times. So I think that's pretty cool. The other thing, and we talk about cons here, I did say, hey, make sure you're critically thinking, make sure that you're good at a lot of things and you're bringing it all within the lens of AI. I believe that is a huge shift in the way that we operate and the way that we solve problems and value in the world. But there is another big con here, guys. There's a big con. And that is, will you be able to think for yourself? Will you be able to critically think? Especially if you're a younger person. And I don't want to throw my Gen Zs and my Gen Alphas under the bus. I've got a 6-year-old and 9-year-old. This is something that I worry about. Will they be able to think critically? How do I raise them now? Are they reading books? Are they writing? Are they considering different ideas? Or are they just consuming what's ever on Netflix or what's ever on the tablet all the time? I don't, you know, we got to be thinking about this, guys, when we're raising our children. Because I do see a world where we start to lose the ability to critically think for ourselves. And by the way, this is substantiated by facts, by data, by studies. I actually recorded a video on this. I'm gonna post a link to it right here, where MIT released a study that says people that are using ChatGPT are just becoming retarded. They're not being able to think for themselves. It's kind of like, basically they made the correlation of using AI is kind of like cramming for a test. You're able to solve the problem immediately, but you're not actually retaining any of the data. You're not retaining any of the information. So you're not actually learning, you're cramming and getting the answer right, but you haven't actually learned anything long-term. So anyway, check out that video. I think it's really interesting, informative as far as how AI is impacting us. Okay, so let's talk about the other major feature, which is the Meta Wrist Neural Band. And this is how you control the screen. So you've got this little screen in your eyeball, but how do you control that, right? The goal here is to get you away from your phone and get you into your glasses, which is, again, a huge shift. We're gonna talk about one of the big cons here in just a moment, but the Meta Neural Band is interesting. What it does is it wraps around your wrist. There's no screen on it, anything like that. But what it does is it measures and understands the muscle work within your wrist. And it allows you to subtly control your AI screen display just by making kind of interesting, unique motions with your hands. So it can probably look like everyone's walking around having spasms. And this leads, I think, is a really cool idea. It's really cool innovation. However, there's an amount of education that's gonna need to go along with this new technology. You know, when someone pops open their phone, it's very easy for someone to understand what they're doing. Oh, I, I want to double click on this, so I click it with my finger. Okay, when it comes to a meta neural band, you're going to need to be like doing all these weird sign language things with your fingers, with your wrists, with your hands. You know, are people going to be able to pick that up? Maybe. Is it going to happen quick? Is it, you know, how much education is required? The more education that's required, the harder it's going to be for people to pick things up. In my experience in, you know, the sales and marketing world, we want as little friction as possible. The more I have to train someone, the more pages there are, the greater the chances that they churn out or they don't end up completing the sequence and getting to our desired result. And I think that is a potential problem here. However, it is definitely innovative. It's revolutionary in the way that we navigate technology in a big way. But, you know, it's a big gamble. It's a big gamble by Meta. I mean, they're putting in crazy money into this project, and if it doesn't pay off, they could lose out. So we'll see how it goes. I mean, honestly, I think this is a big opportunity for Apple. I don't want to go too big into Apple, but, you know, Apple has been notorious for really innovating the next generation of how we operate the world, the iPhone, the earbuds, the iPad. Is this Meta's space? I don't know. We'll see, because they're really going after it hard. Super, super cool. I think it's interesting. The other thing that I think is relevant here is the battery life. You get up to 6 hours of battery life in the glasses. If you have the charging case, it says you can get up to 30 hours. I don't know exactly how that works. The charging case is remote, so you can just kind of carry it in your pocket, and maybe after your battery dies, you can throw it in there and charge it up in half hour. I'm not exactly sure how that works. I think it's a pretty impressive battery life, but I gotta be honest, I am so sick of having to charge everything. Charge my phone, charge my earbuds, charge my watch, charge my, you're charging your shoe, like you're charging everything these days. And I don't know about you, but I'm so sick of remembering everything that I need to have charged. Like the less stuff I have to charge, you know, and now if you're telling me, well, you also have to charge your glasses and the charge box, the carrying case, and the neural band, it's like, okay, what next? Like everything is electronic these days. And in one way is I love the convenience. I'm just so sick of having to remember to charge everything. And you know, you forget to charge one thing and everything is off because you're so reliant on this technology. How do I function? How do I function without my phone? Ah, what do I do? I'm kind of over it. So another thing to charge, don't love that. So anyways, a lot of cool stuff to look at here. I think it's really interesting. What are the business applications? How is this actually going to change the way that we operate in a professional landscape? Okay, so there's a bunch of obvious. If you come up with a cool idea, post it below. And I just want to point out, guys, that we're living, and I talk about this a lot. If you're frequenting the channel, if you're watching all my videos, if you're reading the newsletter at AIUpdate.ai, you should definitely subscribe to the newsletter at AIUpdate.ai. Sharing the latest, most important news, at least in my world, and stuff that's going to impact you as a man who wants to remain relevant, respected, financially free. Sign up for the newsletter, guys. What are you doing? It's completely free. AIUpdate.ai. Send that out every Saturday. So the point I'm trying to make here is the world that we're in now is very much about solving problems. A lot of the problems that you've been solving in the past, you're not gonna need to solve those anymore because AI and robots are gonna start to solve those problems. What is the next problem? How does the new technology create new problems? How can I jump onto these new sources of problems to solve? And that's the way I'm thinking about the world. I honestly, I don't know what I'm gonna be doing in the next 2 to 5 to 10 years, but I know I'm gonna continually reinvent myself. I'm gonna study the market. I'm gonna find new interesting problems to solve. I'm gonna leverage my past experiences and the problems I've solved in the past to solve new problems. That's what it's all about, solving new problems. And so let's look at how, you know, what are some of the new problems, or what are some problems that these new glasses solve, okay? Thanks for being here, by the way. Smash that like button, I appreciate you. So one, which sounds fairly obvious, is a surgical assistant for telemedicine, right? Maybe you've got a nurse practitioner that's on site, she's got the glasses on, she's doing all the you know, she's looking, she's diagnosing, blah, 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 but well, guess what? I can have the MD can fly in and via these goggles, via these glasses, and see exactly what the nurse is seeing. You know, you can also use AI to help supplement. You know, there's a study, forgive me, I don't remember the exact statistic, but if I'm not mistaken, it showed that, and this was like a year ago that I read this, that AI models are 60% more effective at finding cancer on x-rays and MRIs. just way better at looking at these charts and graphs and than the human eye. So being able to use the AI there to assist the nurse or the doctor, having experts be able to view in and see exactly what the person is seeing could be a huge, huge deal. The next is really obvious, and as a marketer, this is something I look at. It's interactive retail and augmented reality. Someone's got a pair of shoes you really like. Hey Meta, where can I buy those? Add them to cart. Boom, done. You're walking through the mall, there's gonna be ads popping up everywhere. It's actually gonna be pretty insane. You're gonna just see these virtual reality, augmented reality ads popping up everywhere. You're gonna be able to run ads that are custom to people. Where are you at right now? Flash them an ad. You're in a store, get 50% off. So you can start to see how everything that you see and you look at, think about the way QR codes work, but it's QR codes on steroids because it's being pumped right into someone's visual box, if you would. So I think someone who's in marketing, I think that's really interesting. How can we leverage these types of tools to filter in and get right to people's eyeballs? Offsite optimization, I think, is another interesting one. Let's say that you are managing an Amazon warehouse and you have a few employees on there, because at this point, almost, there's more robots than humans in these Amazon warehouses. By the way, I record an entire video on how many robots are in Amazon warehouses. You can check that out right here. Having someone like someone at a control center be able to say, hey Jim, go check out Bay A1, and then seeing exactly what they see, looking for problems, checking on inventory, working on construction projects, security. Anytime you have like maybe one or two humans on site, having a manager or someone who's off site, someone who's an expert, be able to see what they see is obviously valuable. And I think that's interesting. Real-time travel assistance and whatnot, I think, is interesting too. Someone's walking through Rome and the AI they're not sure about, you could easily just call someone. So that's kind of an interesting niche. If you're a travel agent, you're trying to find a way to adjust because nobody is talking travel agents anymore. Well, maybe if you say, hey, I'm offering a very premium service. Here's your Meta glasses. As you're walking around Rome, you can call me anytime and I'll be able to explain to you what you're looking at in real time. And probably much more interesting than the crappy earbuds they give you or earphones they give you when you're walking into a certain place. Sports analytics integrations, wearing these AI wearables, glasses can help to get more data, and media. And I think this is a really interesting one too. Imagine if Patrick Mahomes is wearing these for a football game, and for an additional $100 a month, you can actually see exactly what Patrick Mahomes sees. That's pretty freaking cool. That's pretty cool. And you can see how that could start to impact a lot of the sports world in real time. I think that's cool. First-person experiences. I mean, I think it's been proven that first-person shooters are absolutely massive, absolutely huge. People, it's going to be a really easy switch to go from someone, who's playing first-person types of video games into first-person types of multimedia. I could see that being a big implication there as well. And so again, new problems, new innovations lead to new problems. They lead to new interesting innovations. And I just think it's a very interesting time to be alive. What do you think? $800. Would you pay for these? Would you pay for $800 Meta glasses right now? Me, I'm on the fence. Quite frankly, I probably won't. I want to see the bugs get turned out. And I want to see, it's kind of this interesting problem where you need to have more people using them to get the maximum benefit. I will probably jump on when I start to see business implications and I can start to innovate and create unique solutions. We'll see. I'll let you know. When I check them out, when I get them, when I start hooking them up with clients and leveraging them as a tool, I will let you know, because I think they're super cool, super interesting. And I've gone long enough in this video. Appreciate you watching. If you enjoyed this, you're definitely gonna like yesterday's video where I talk about the H-1B visa program. Trump just banned it, or did he not? What's the changes? What's happening? How is this gonna impact the tech world? We covered the whole thing there. It's got tens of thousands of views on it. You definitely wanna check out that video. In the meantime, be blessed. Go check out the glasses and let me know your thoughts in the comments below. All right, guys, see ya. Peace.